I'd first like to start off by thanking John Bennett and the students, First String, etc., for providing the music in the lobby. Let's give them a big round of applause. I'd also like those of you who are able to donate to the Interrel Donor Fund. Because of your generosity, we were able to defray a significant portion of the rental of the Bushnell. And given the economic climate, it was even more amazing that the response was so significant. Thank you so much for doing that. I want to let you also know that since I haven't paid the bill yet, well, you can follow my thinking there. This year marks the retirement of longtime Norfelt vocal music teacher Brenda Wirth. Brenda came to West Hartford in 1974 and since then has touched the lives of thousands upon thousands of students with her caring and in the loving way in which she teaches children. Beyond that, she's been an amazing mentor to so many of our music teachers here in West Hartford. Tonight is special for Brenda in two ways. She's going to conduct the finale, but in addition to that, her son Matt, who has a very successful career in the opera, is going to be a guest soloist with the Interrel Choir. So we are coming full circle tonight because, check this out, Matt was a member of Interrel in 1989, 20 years ago. Well, I have lots of favorite parts of Interrel, and actually tour day is probably my most favorite part because it's the first time that the children get to perform and they are so excited. They're all dressed up, and I actually heard from one parent the day of who I know who said his daughter couldn't sleep the night before. And I love going to Fern Park to see them. They have their lunch there and they're playing and it's, well, it looks like Norman Rockwell painting to me. It's just so wonderful. But when I leave, I always come away with a few of the things that I've heard students say that are just too precious not to share with you. So I'll make it brief, but this one was particularly interesting. I was so nervous and excited that I think I passed out during the concert. That was the best. And another one was actually from one of our teachers who said, who won't be named tonight, who said, I can't believe that we're putting our good reputation and career in the hands of 9 and 10-year-olds. It's a wonderful night tonight for all of us, for the community, for parents, for friends, for relatives. You probably were told to silence your cell phone, and I'm going to add this. Silence all the other voices in your mind tonight. Let this be the one focus. This will be a very special night that you'll remember for a long time, and so will your children. This is an unforgettable night of music. I think it's one that you can put in your memory banks to savor for years to come when they're older. It also might come in handy when they're teenagers. When you want something really wonderful to remember, you'll remember Interrel. This year also marks the retirement of Dr. David Scolaro, our superintendent of schools. You have to have a strong parent community to have a great arts program. It starts right there. The parents have to believe in the arts, support the arts, have 2,000 people in the audience. That's a big part. You have to have great teachers, principals who support what you do, administrators, a terrific curriculum. But if you don't have the superintendent of schools right there with you, you can't have a great arts education. And that's become increasingly difficult in the past few years. For as long as I've known David, he has been a passionate and vocal advocate of the arts. You know, he talks the talk, but he also walks the walk, and that's really important. He's also said that arts education is one of the four pillars of education, and I don't know many superintendents who would get up and speak so passionately about the arts. We have been very fortunate to have Dr. Scholars as our superintendent of the schools for these years. And recently, West Hartford was named as one of the 100 best communities for music education in the country. This performance, this performance, your attendance here tonight, the wonderful music you're going to hear requires everyone to work together. Ladies and gentlemen, please acknowledge and give a warm welcome and thank you to our Superintendent of Schools, Dr. David Scholars.
I'm humbled by those words and honored. It truly has been my privilege to be part of this community and part of the music program especially. You know, I had some prepared text, but Hyde has kind of like said it all about the participation of you as families. This will probably be the only time, those of you who've known me for 14 years, that you'll hear the name David Scholars and speechless in the same sentence. You know, it's been a privilege of mine to be able to combine my love of music and my love of children in my life's work, and especially in a community like this. But I've only done, my part has only been a small part. The applause and the recognition really goes out to all of you in the audience today, family and friends who have supported the music program and arts education in West Hartford Public Schools. Without you, we would have no program, and my challenge would be even more difficult. You know, we've seen it during good times, and it's easy to say arts are important during the good times. It's not so easy during the hard times, and I hope you continue the fight to maintain arts as a valuable part of every child's education. And also the applause and the honor should go out to the teachers who have dedicated themselves to being a part of the West Hartford Public Schools. And you're going to see their work this evening and their dedication. But tonight, what you're really going to see, and we're really going to get the greater applause, are from the children and the talents that they demonstrate. None of that would have been possible without great teachers, great support at home. And tonight, is there going to be that magical moment when it all comes together? It really is a celebration of everybody. And I know for every child here, it will be a memory that will last for a lifetime. And I know the 14 years that I've stood here and introduced this program and sat in the audience and watched it from the beginning to the end, and watch the risers rise when the choral singers begin, will also be a memory that I will carry for a lifetime. So enough of that, let's let the show begin. Thank you.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem and join me in welcoming the 2009 Inter-Elementary School Orchestra. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. To honor the retirement of Dr. Sklar's, the Interhell Choir will be singing a written song for his passion of sailing. We hope that our voices will sail him into a bright future.
A sailor's life is a lie. When I was a lad, I served a term as office boy to an attorney's firm. I cleaned the windows and I swept the floor, and I polished up the handle on the big front door.
He polished up the handle on the big front door.
I polished up the handle so carefully that now I'm the ruler of the Queen's Navy.
He polished up the handle so carefully that now he's the ruler of the Queen's Navy.
As office boy, I made such a mark that they gave me the post of a junior clerk. I served the writs with smiles so bland, copied all the letters with a big round hand.
He copied all the letters with a big round hand.
I copied all the letters with a hand so big that now I'm the ruler of the Queen's Navy.
He copied all the letters with a hand so big that now he's the ruler of the Queen's Navy.
In the serving writs I made such a name that an article clerk I soon became. I wore clean collars and a brand new suit for the pass examination at the Institute.
The pass examination at the Institute.
And that pass examination did so well for me that now I'm the ruler of the Queen's Navy.
The pass examination did so well for him that now he's the ruler of the Queen's Navy.
I grew so rich that I was sent by a pocket burr into Parliament. I always voted at my party's door and never thought of thinking for myself at all.
He never thought of thinking for himself at all.
I thought so little, they rewarded me by making me the ruler of the Queen's Navy.
He thought so little, they rewarded him by making him the ruler of the Queen's Navy.
And now, landsmen all, whoever you may be, if you want to rise to the top of the tree, if your soul isn't fed to an office stool, be careful to be guided by this golden rule.
Be careful to be guided by this golden rule.
Stay close to your desks and never, ever go to sea. And you may all be rulers of the Queen's Navy.
Stay close to your desks and never go to sea. And you all may be rulers of the Queen's Navy.
Thank you.
Before we have our finale, and as the children are lining up and the orchestra is coming on, I'd like to thank a number of people and also remind you that all of your children will be exiting through the lobby. So we're going to meet them all out there. There are so many people that are important to making this happen, and I'd like to go through a wonderful list of all of them now. Heather Schweiger, our Interrail Festival Coordinator, her first year doing that. I'd like you to know that the people here at the Bushnell are absolutely wonderful. They're great to work with. It's a great place to be. I'd also, right now, like to acknowledge the composer of Once More to the Sea, our very own Rob Hugh, Wolcott music teacher. Rob, please stand up. There are so many pieces to this organization at the Education Center, and we could not make this happen if it weren't for two of the people in my office. They are absolutely amazing, Deb Berman and Terry Anselmo. We are so very fortunate to have the support of our elementary principals. They're right over there. Ladies and gentlemen, they make this all work for us. You have been a tremendous audience this evening. It's what we always hope for. You know, performers of all ages respond to applause, and you've been generous and gracious. And you've made a memorable night for every one of these children, conductor performers. And now I'd like to introduce and acknowledge the conductors and managers of the Interrail 2009. Ladies and gentlemen, our teachers. You can give someone two for now, but only for now. We are very fortunate to have such a dedicated staff. And before they leave, I would just like to express to them and to you the many hours that they spend just poring over repertoire to play, and the amount of time they spend talking to each other, fussing over every little detail that makes the music beautiful. They do this as a labor of love, and that's what it truly is. One more round of applause for them. And now we'd like to do our finale, America the Beautiful, and this will be conducted by Brenda Wirth and Dr. Amanda Leon Guerrero, America the Beautiful.